The Reserve Bank today again decided not to cut interest rates. It couldn't, not while inflation's this high, 3.8%, higher than Britain, the US, New Zealand. And worse, Reserve Bank Governor Michelle Bullock said today she's not expecting underlying inflation to get down to where it should be for at least another year or more.
According to our current forecasts, it's not really forecast to come back sustainably into the band until 2026.
The book today also listed a lot of other negatives she's seeing now, weak growth, people spending less, weak productivity too, which is not surprising with all the government's new pro-union laws. But Treasurer Jim Chalmers once again blamed everyone else, foreigners particularly, interest rates, and not his own high spending, high immigration, union-pleasing government for Australians getting poorer per person.
We've seen growth in our economy has been quite weak. We've seen consumption has been weak. Discretionary spending has been going backwards. All of this is indications that the interest rate rises already in the system are already combining with international uncertainty and persistent inflation to slow our economy quite substantially. And we saw that in the most recent national accounts.
Oh, unlucky Jim. Has there ever been an unluckier treasurer? But Jim Chalmers hinted there could be great news tomorrow.
Whether that monthly inflation data is in the low threes or the high twos, it will show that inflation has halved since we came to office. That's a good thing. We are making welcome and encouraging progress.
Inflation under 3%. New figures tomorrow. Michelle Bullock actually said the same. Could be. Except she did point out that's because the government is temporarily subsidising our electricity bills, and that's a cheat. Joining me is our Tuesday regular commentator, Matt Canavan, the National Senator and former Resources Minister. Matt Canavan, good to see you. Look, all this, I think, shows the mess the Albanese government's in. Driving up electricity prices and inflation with its green agenda and then paying part of our electricity bills to hide the pain.
You're absolutely right, Andrew. It's a total mess. And what the Anthony Albanese government is doing is the equivalent of your kids cleaning their room by chucking everything in their cupboard. I mean, I've done that sometimes for my wife, you know. You chuck all the mess into the cupboard. You say, I've cleaned it. I've cleaned the house. It's all done. But, of course, what's going to happen is that stuff's just going to come out of the cupboard very soon and it'll all be a mess again. And that's exactly what's happening here, that the Albanese government has transferred the high energy prices they presided over, despite promising lower prices, ended up with higher electricity prices, much, much higher. They're transferring the payment of that from your quarterly bill to your annual tax statement because you're going to have to pay for these subsidies. Now, the measured inflation is going to come in lower, but it's just a cooking the books exercise. And the RBA governor's made it very clear that she will look through that. She's not going to cut interest rates because measured inflation has magically fallen because of Jim's tricks. She will keep interest rates high because inflation, underlying inflation, remains high. Unlike that in other countries around the world, the United States had a 50 basis point cut in their interest rates just last week. And if that was to happen here, the average Australian would be almost $200 a month better off on their mortgage. That's the price that you're all paying because this government hasn't been able to solve the energy crisis, hasn't got a plan for productivity, and we've ended up with the highest inflation in the world and persistently high interest rates.
Now, Matt, I'm going to ask you to praise the government now because it's done something that I wouldn't have thought was on the agenda if its net zero target was really viable. It's just approved three coal mine extensions in the Hunter Valley. That's good news, isn't it?
Look, I do welcome that. It's a little bit late, but better late than never. These approvals have been held up for a long time. I just spoke to some companies in the past few weeks that were waiting with bated breath for this because they want to create jobs, they want to get the investment going. I mean, this shows two things, Andrew. One, I think the government is in a panic mode now after the reaction from its refusal, inexplicable refusal. I mean, inexplicable, they haven't explained it. They refuse to explain why they've shut down a gold mine in Orange, costing 800 jobs there. Now they're in panic mode trying to react. The other thing it shows is obviously there's still very strong demand for coal because these mines want to get going. As investors, we hear that there's no one who wants to invest in coal. Well, clearly there's very strong demand for our coal. I'm here tonight on the Gold Coast with 100 people here from the Climate Energy Realist Group who know about this and they're desperate for a solution. to our own energy crisis, but we're shipping all our coal overseas to help other countries. Why don't we keep some of it here and use it as well for our own needs?